Hello students, this is our 11th session of chapter 3 data representation. In this session we are going to learn how to do subtraction using 1's and 2's complement. Subtraction using 1's complement. Subtraction using 1's complement. Here we come across two cases. Case 1 is subtracting a larger number from a smaller number, and case 2 is subtracting a smaller number from a larger number. Case 1, subtracting a smaller number from a larger number. What is the first step? Step 1 is we have to find out the 1's complement of the subtrahend. Find the 1's complement of the subtrahend. Second step is add this to the minuend. Add this to the minuend. So carry is generated. This carry is called as the end around carry. Carry is generated. This carry is called as end around carry. Step 4, add the end around carry to the LSP to get the final difference. Step 4 is add the end around carry back to the LSB to get the difference. So what is the first step? The first case is subtracting a smaller number from a larger number. So in this first step is we have to find out the 1's complement of the subtrahend. In the second step we have to add this 1's complement of the subtrahend to the minuend. In the third step, carry is generated. So that carry is called as end around carry. That carry is called as end around carry. And in the step 4, we are going to add this carry to the LSP to get the difference. Now let's solve the problem. First problem. Subtract 15 from 23 using 1's complement. what we have to do here, we have to subtract 15 from 23, which is nothing but 23 minus 15, a smaller number from a larger number. Here 15 is a smaller number and 23 is the larger number. So 23 minus 15. What is 23 minus 15? Which is nothing but 8 is the difference. We have to get 8 as the answer. So in this, 23 is the minuend and 15 is the subtrahend. 15 is the subtrahend. 23 is the minuend and 15 is the subtrahend. So what is the first step? In the first step, we have to find the ones complement of the subtrahend. So before that, we have to write the binary code for 23 and 15. What is the binary code for 23? Using 16, 8, 4, 2, 1 code, we have to represent 23. How to represent 23? 16 plus 4 becomes 20. 20 plus 2 becomes 22. 22 plus 1 becomes 23. So in the place of 8, you have to put 0. So the binary value of 23 is 10111. Next, how to represent 15? 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1 becomes 15. So the binary code for 15 is 0111. Now what we have to do? We have to find the ones complement of 15. We have to find the ones complement of the subtrahend. So what is the ones complement of the subtrahend? The ones complement of subtrahend 0111 is. How to find the ones complement? By changing each zeros to 1 and each ones to 0. So the ones complement of 0111 is 10000. So this is the ones complement of the subtrahend. In the second step, what we have to do? We have to add this to the minuend. We have to add this to the minuend. What is the minuend value? 10111 plus 10000. What is 1 plus 0? 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 carry. So this carry is called as end around carry. So this is called as end around carry. What we have to do now? In the last step, we have to add the end around carry to this LSB to find the difference. So this position is called as MSB and this is our LSB. So I am going to add this end around carry at LSB. What is 1 plus 1? 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 carry. Again, 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 carry. 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 carry. What is 1 plus 0? 1 plus 0 is 1, 0. So what is our final value? That is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. Check whether the obtained value is correct or not. So what is the binary code for 8? That is 1000. So we got 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, which is equal to 8. Hence the obtained value is correct. Next problem. subtract 14 from 20. Subtract 14 from 20. So what is 20 minus 14? Which is nothing but 6. Right. So here 20 is our minuend. And 14 is our subtrahend. 14 is our subtrahend. Yes. What we have to do? The first step is we have to find out the ones complement of the subtrahend. Before that, we have to write the binary code of 20 and 14. So, using 16, 8, 4, 2, 1 code, we are going to represent 20. So, how to represent 20? 16 plus 4 becomes 20. So, in the rest of the places, we have to put zeros. So, 16 plus 4 becomes 20. What about 14? That is 8 plus 4 becomes 12. 12 plus 2 becomes 14. So, in rest of the places, we have to put zeros. So, the binary equivalent of 20 is 10100. And the binary equivalent of 14 is 01110. What is the first step? We have to find out the ones complement of the subtrahend. So, what is the ones complement of the subtrahend? Change each zeros to 1 and each 1 to 0. That is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So, this is our ones complement of 01110. Now, add this ones complement value, that is 10100 plus 10001. Now add the binary values. So what is 0 plus 1? 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 1 is 0. 1 carry. So this carry is called as end around carry. And this is our MSB and this is our LSB. So what we have to do? We have to add this 1 at LSB. What is 1 plus 1? 1 plus 1 is nothing but 0, 1 carry. What is 1 plus 0? 1 plus 0 is 1, 1, 0, 0. So, 4 plus 2 becomes 6. Hence, the obtained value is correct. That is 6. So, this is how we are going to do the subtraction using ones complement. Next is second case, that is subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. Subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. So, what is the first step? The first step is to find the ones complement of the subtrahend. Find the ones complement of the subtrahend. Find the ones complement of the subtrahend. What is step 2? Step 2 is we have to add this to the minuend. Add this to the minuend. In the step 3, there will be no carry. There will be no carry. Re-complement the answer to get the difference What is step 4? Step 4 is add the end around carry back to the LSB. To get the difference. While subtracting a larger number from a smaller number, first we have to find out the ones complement of the subtrahend. In the second step, we have to add this to the minuend. In the third step, there will be no carry. So we have to re-complement the answer to get the difference. So add the end around carry back to the LSB to get the difference. Let's solve the problem. First problem is subtract 52 from 25 using ones complement. Subtract 52 from 25 using ones complement. So here 52 is a larger number and 25 is our smaller number. So we are subtracting 52 from 25. That is 25 minus 52. 25 minus 52. So what is the value? That is minus 27. Minus 27. So 25 is our minuend. 52 is our subtrahend. So first we have to write the binary equivalent of 25 as well as 52. So using 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1 code, we are going to represent 25 as well as 52. So what is the binary equivalent of 25? That is 16 plus 8 becomes 24 plus 1 becomes 25. In rest of the places, we have to put zeros. What about 52? 32 plus 16 becomes 48. 48 plus 4 becomes 52. In rest of the places, we have to put zeros. So hence the binary equivalent of 25 is 011001, and the binary equivalent of 52 is 110100. So what is the first step? We have to find out the ones complement of the subtrahend. Ones complement of the subtrahend. So what is the ones complement of the subtrahend? Which is nothing but 00101. So how to find out the ones complement? Changing each zeros to 1 and each ones to zeros. Next, we have to add this ones complement to the minuend. What is our minuend? 011001 plus ones complement, which is nothing but 001011. So now add the binary values. What is 1 plus 1? It is 0, 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. So here there is no carry. Here there is no carry. So what is the next step? We have to re-complement the answer to get the difference. So again we have to re-complement this answer. Re-complement. That is 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. 0, 11, 0, 11. So check the answer now. So this is nothing but 16 plus 8 is 24. 24 plus 2 is 26. 26 plus 1 is 27. Hence the obtained answer is correct. So how to represent minus 27? So these are all the magnitude of 27. And this bit represents the signed bit. So this 0 represents minus here, negative symbol. So the 0 represents negative symbol, and rest of the bits represent the binary equivalent of 27. Hence the value of 25 minus 52 is minus 27. So the 0 represents minus symbol, and the rest of the bits represents the value of 27. So using ones and two complement, that is subtraction using ones complement, there are two cases. First case is we are subtracting a smaller number from a larger number, and in the second case we are subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. So in subtracting larger number, first step is we have to find the ones complement of the subtrahend. In the second step, we have to add this to the minuend. In the third step, carry is generated. That carry is called as end around carry. In the fourth step, we are adding that end around carry to the LSP to get the difference. When comes to case 2, that is subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. First step, we have to find the ones complement of the subtrahend. In the second step, we have to add this to the minuend. In the third step, there will be no carry. So what we have to do? We have to re-complement the answer to get the difference. In the fourth step, add the end around carry back to the LSP to get the difference. So here we didn't get any carries, so we just re-complement and we got the answer. Thank you.